What revels are in hand? Is there no play to ease the anguish of a torturing hour? Call Philostrate.
Here, mighty Theseus.
Say, what abridgment have you for this evening?
There is a list.
A tedious, brief scene of young Pyrrhus and his love Thisbe. Very tragical mirth. Merry and tragical, tedious and brief.
A play there, my lord, some 10 words long, which is as brief as I have known a play, and by 10 words, my lord, it is too long.
What are they that do play it?
Hard-handed men that work in Athens here.
We will hear it.
No, my noble lord, it is not for you. I have heard it over.
We will hear that play.
But not just yet, our play begins 4 days earlier. These three couples weren't yet married, and these 6 proud workmen hadn't begun to rehearse their play. We are in Athens in Greece over 3,000 years ago. Theseus rules here, and he's about to marry Hippolyta. How these two couples came to be married is our play.
4 days ago, as Theseus and Hippolyta look forward to their happy day, they meet Aegeus, Hermia's father, and he is not happy. In Athens, the law says that father can decide which man his daughter should marry. If she refuses, the only options are either death or to become a nun.
What's the news with thee?
Full of vexation am I with complaint against my child, my daughter Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander. My gracious Duke, this man hath bewitched the bosom of my child.
What say you, Hermia?
Oh, with my father look, but with my eyes.
Rather arise, must with his judgment look.
Lysander, yield thy crazed title to my certain right.
I am, my lord, as well derived as he. My love is more than his, and I am beloved of beauteous Hermia. Demetrius made love to Henry, and she dotes on him.
I must confess that I have heard so much. Take time to pause for Hermia until the next new moon, the seething day betwixt my love and me. Demetrius, Aegeus, come, you shall go with me.
Never did run smooth.
But Lysander has a plan. He has a rich aunt who is 20 miles away where the strict laws of Athens do not apply. If Hermia can sneak out of her house by tomorrow night and meet Lysander in the woods, they can run away together. No sooner have they agreed than Helena turns up.
Good speed, fair Helena.
Call you me fair? Demetrius loves your fair. Oh, teach me how you look and with what art you sway the motion of Demetrius' heart.
The more I hate, the more he follows me.
The more I love, the more he hates me.
Take comfort, he shall no more see my face. Lysander and myself shall fly this place.
As time its lover's flight doth still conceal, through Athens gates we have devised to steal.
And in the woods to don our retreat, there my Lysander and myself shall meet.
We will, my Hermia.
Helena, adieu. Eyes are on him. Demetrius, dote on you.
I'll tell Demetrius fair Hermia's flight. Then will Then to the wood will he tomorrow night pursue her, and for this intelligence I'll have thanks. It's a dear expense.
Which button do I press?
Hello, is anyone there?
Hello, can you hear me?
Oh yes, I can hear you. Snap, can you hear me?
Oh yes, I can hear you.
Is this going to take long? I'm doing a vlog how to make a fence in 20 minutes.
Is this working?
I've never done a Zoom before.
Seems to be working.
Where are the coins?
I'm here, just haven't turned my camera on.
Right, is everyone here? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Still working?
Yes.
I'm going to put you on mute. Unmute yourselves if you want to talk. Nod and give me the thumbs up if you understand.
Tell us, Peter Quince, what play are we doing?
The sad comedy and most cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
A very good piece of work. Now, Peter Quince, tell us our role.
Nick Bottom the Weaver, you are going to be Pyramus.
What is Pyramus, a lover or a tyrant?
A lover that gives himself most gallant for love.
I will be good at that.
Francis Flute, the bellow mender, you will be Thisbe.
What is Thisbe? A wandering knight?
It is a lady that Pyramus must love.
Don't make me play a woman, for I have a beard coming.
Let me play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice. Thisbe! Thisbe!
Ah! Ah! Pyramus! My lover there! My lady there!
No, no, you must play Pyramus and flute you Thisbe. Start to join us?
Yes, Peter Quince.
You must play the lion's part.
Have you written the lion's part? As I've got a long one at the moment.
You can make it up, it's nothing but roaring.
I can be the lion too. My roar will be so amazing that the Duke will want me to say it again.
You can play no part but Pyramus. I'll email you the script. Let's meet in the woods. We can rehearse and social distance there.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
Come on, everyone's in there. Might as well leave now myself.
Everybody's left.
Oh, that's could have read that one earlier.
The wood is becoming a popular destination, but unknown to the lovers who plan to meet there or the amateur actors planning to rehearse there, the wood is already the playground of more creatures of the night. Fairies. But Oberon, the king of the fairies, is not getting on with Titania, his queen. They both want a little changeling child to be their page boy.
How unfortunate to meet you here in the moonlight, proud Titania.
Oh, what, jealous Oberon? Come on, fairies, let's go.
You don't need him.
Come on.
Yeah,
I never liked
him. He's annoying.
We've got some stuff to do.
Very disgusting.
He has other things to do.
Yeah.
Come on.
Let's go.
No. Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
Go.
On.
Run.
Not so fast, Titania. Give me that boy.
Not in the fairy kingdom. Fairies away.
Oberon does not like to be outwitted, so he calls for his mischief maker, whose name is Puck, and sends him to find a magic flower.
When he squeezes the juice from this flower onto Titania's sleeping eyelids, she'll fall in love with whatever creature she first sees when she wakes.
While she is distracted by this creature, he will persuade her to give him the changeling boy.
When Oberon hears people approaching, he makes himself invisible.
I don't love you, so stop following me. I tell you I do not, no I cannot, love you.
And even for that, I love you the more.
I'm sick when I do look on thee.
And I'm sick when I look not on you. We should be wooed and we're not made to woo.
When Puck returns with the flower, Oberon takes him to speed into the eyelids. But what he's just seen gives him another idea to use the love potion to make Demetrius love Helena.
Sweet Athenian lady is in love with the disdainful youth. Anoint his eye, but when the next thing he sees will be the lady.
Fear not, my lord.
Come sing me now asleep and then to your office and let me rest.
When you awake, fall in love with by mistake. When you wake, its sight enders. Wake when something nasty nears.
Titania isn't the only one who is tired. Lysander has lost his way, and he and Hermia are exhausted, so they decide to sleep until the morning. Not together, of course, but separately.
Puck comes search for Demetrius so that he can put the love potion in his eyes and make him fall in love with Helena. He doesn't realise the man sleeping on the floor ground is Lysander, who is in love with Hermia.
"This must be he," my master said, "who hates the Athenian maids. And when you awake, fall in love with she."
"Stay.
Do not haunt me thus."
"But who is here? Lysander on the ground, dead or asleep? I see no blood, no wound. Lysander, be the good sir, wake.
I will run through fire for my sweet sake. Not tell you, but Helena I love. Who will not change a raven for a dove?"
"Good troth, you do me wrong. Good sooth, you do me in such dateful manner. Me to woo, fare you well."
"She sees not Hermia. Hermia, seat thou there, and never mayst thou come Lysander near. All my powers address my love and to honour Helen and to be her knight."
"Help me, Lysander, help me!"
"What out of hearing, gone, no sound, no word. Then I perceive that you will not deny either death or your unbind immediately."
Has done what his master has asked and found an Athenian youth, but Oberon wanted Demetrius, not Lysander, to fall in love with Helena, with Titanian still sleeping nearby. The workmen arrived to rehearse their play.
"Are we all here?"
Yeah.
"Right, on time, and here's the perfect place for a socially distant rehearsal."
Just then, Puck arrives, unnoticed. He soon finds the chance to make mischief.
"Oh, this is so
good.
Pyramus, you begin. When you've spoken your speech, go into those bushes.
Thisbe, the flowers of odious, savour sweet.
Odorous.
Odorous, savour sweet. So hath my breath, my dearest Thisbe dear, but hark a voice.
Must I speak now?"
Yes, for you must understand. Here goes to see what made the noise he heard.
"Most radiant Pyramus, red rose on triumphant brier, I will, as truest horse would never tire, I will meet thee, Pyramus, at Ninny's tomb."
"Ninny's tomb, man, you must speak all part at once. Cues and all Pyramus, your cue is never tire."
"If I were there, Thisbe would be mine."
"Oh my god, you're so weird."
Oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, o
icy bottom, you have been transformed.
They're trying to scare me. They're trying to make an ass out of me. I'm going to sing to make it so they fit, so they know that I am brave. Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
What angel wakes me from my flowery bed?
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
Your singing has moved me on the first view to say, to swear I love thee.
Mistress, you have no reason to love me.
Thou art as wise, thou art as beautiful. Please blossom, cobweb, moth, bluebell and mustard seed. Come wait upon him, do what he says. My love's tongue, bring him silently.
Oberon is waiting in another part of the wood. When Puck arrives, he tells him how he has found some axes in the wood and played the trick on one called Bottom by giving him an ass's head, and how Bottom's singing had then woken Titania.
So it came to pass, Titania waked and straightway loved an ass.
This falls out better than I could devise, but hast thou yet latched the Athenian's arms with the love juice, as I did bid thee do?
I take him sleeping. That is finished too.
Puck believes he has done what Oberon ordered and made Demetrius fall in love with Helena.
Stand close, the same Athenian.
This is a woman, but this is not the man.
Hermia is certain Demetrius has killed Lysander whilst he was sleeping.
Hast thou slain him then, henceforth never to be numbered among men?
You spend your passion on a misplaced mood. I am not guilty of Lysander's blood, nor is he dead, for aught that I can tell.
I pray thee, then tell me that he is well.
And if I could, what shall I get therefor?
A privilege never to see me more.
There is no following her in this vein. Here is therefore, for a while I will remain.
It's obvious to Oberon that Puck has made a mistake. The wrong man is now in love with poor Hermia. He sends Puck to find Helena as soon as possible.
In the meantime, he drops the love potion into Demetrius's eyelids. He will make sure Helena is the first person he sees when he wakes.
Helen, goddess, nymph, perfect, divine.
Just then, Lysander arrives.
Fair Helen, my love, my life, my soul, fair Helena.
Respite, O help, I see you're all bent to set against me for your merriment. You both are rivals and love Hermia. Now both rivals mock Helena.
Just then, Hermia arrives.
You counterblossom, you thief of love, what have you come by night and stolen my love's hearts from him?
Fie, fie, you counterfeit, you puppet, you
puppet. Why so? Because I'm so dwarfish and so low. How low I am, I'm not yet so low, but my nails can reach to thine eyes.
That does not strike on me, you perhaps may think, because she is something lower than myself, I can max her.
Lower hark again.
Though she be little, she is fierce.
Little again and nothing but little and low. Let me come to her.
Get you gone, you dwarf, you minimus, you beak, you acorn.
Now follow if you dare, try and win over Helena.
Follow? No, I want to fight you.
Oberon is not pleased with Puck's mischief-making, which sets the woman and the man at each other's throats, and he tells Puck to tire everyone out and gives him some different flower magic for Lysander.
Whilst Puck is busy, he will persuade Titania to give him the changeling boy.
I am Sid, Field and Town Goblin. Leap up,
up and down, up and down. I will lead you up and down.
I am Sid, Field and Town Goblin. Leap up and down.
Up and down, up and down.
I will lead you up and down.
I am Sid, Field and Town
Goblin. Leap up and down.
On this flowery bed while I stroke your lovely cheeks.
Where is Moth?
Ready.
Go fetch me a drink to quench my thirst. Where is Peas Blossom?
Ready.
Where is Mustard Seed? Peas Blossom and Mustard Seed. Scratch my head. Where's Cobweb?
Ready.
Get me the honey, the honey of the bumblebee. Careful, do not damage it.
Ready.
Shake hands, Bluebell. There's no need to curtsy.
What can I do for you?
Help them scratch my head.
Sleep now, fairies be gone.
When Puck arrives, Oberon tells him, but Titania had willingly given him a changeling boy.
And now I have the boy, I want to undo this hateful imperfection of her eyes.
Me Oberon, I thought I was in love with an ass.
There lies your love.
Since how did this happen? It looks repulsive now.
Silence a while. Puck, take off his head.
Now, when you wake up, see with your own blue, foolish eyes.
Theseus and Hippolyta's wedding day, which is also the day Hermia has to decide who she should marry.
Early in the morning, Theseus and Hippolyta are out hunting with Aegeus, Hermia's father.
Theseus, my love, look here.
A good morrow, friends.
Pardon, my lord.
I pray you all stand up.
My lord, I cannot truly say how I came here. I came with Hermia hither. Our intern must be gone from us.
Enough! Enough, my lord! You have enough! They could have stolen away Demetrius, thereby to have defeated you and me.
The object and the pleasure of my eye is only Helena. To her, my lord, I was engaged before I saw Hermia.
Fair lovers, you are fortunately met, and yes, I will overbear your will. These couples shall eternally be knit. Away with us to Athens, three and three, will hold a feast in great solemnity. Come, Hippolyta.
Call me and I will answer. God's my life, I have a most rare vision. I will get Peter Quince to write down a ballad of this dream. It shall be called Bottom's Dream, because it hath no bottom.
Thank you.
We will hear that play. Go bring them in.
Very well, my lord. Don't let it up.
In this same play, does it befall that I want a snout by name will play a wall? And such a wall as I would have you think that had a cunning hole or chink, through which lovers, Pyramus and Thisbe, did whisper often, very secretly.
Pyramus draws near the wall, silence.
O thou, O wall, O sweet, O lovely wall, show me your chink to blink through with my eye.
Oh, do better.
Thanks, courteous wall, but what see I? No Thisbe do I see. But what cast be your stones, not for thus deceiving me?
O wall, full often has thou heard my moans, my cherry lips have often kissed thy stones.
I see a voice, I hear my Thisbe's face. Thisbe,
my love, thou art my love, I think.
Will you at Ninny's tomb meet me straight away?
I come without delay.
This is the silliest stuff I've ever heard.
The best in this kind but shadows, and the worst are no worse, if imagination amend them.
It must be your imagination, not theirs. Here comes three noble beasts.
This is old Ninny's tomb. Where is my love?
Thisbe.
Well, Shumrin, truly the moon shines very gracefully.
Sweet moon, I thank thee for the sunny beams. What dreadful woe is here? What dreadful woe is here? Eyes, do you see? How can it be? What stained with blood? Thus die I, thus. Now I am dead, now am I fled. My soul is in the sky. Tongue, loose thy flight. Moon, take thy flight. Now die, 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 die!
Assure my heart that I pity the man.
Sleep, my love. What, dead, my dove? O Pyramus, arise! Farewell, friends, thus is the end.
Moonshine and Lion left and buried the dead.
And war too.
No, I assure you, the wall is down. Will it please you to see the epilogue?
No epilogue, I pray you. Lovers to bed, 'tis almost fairy time.
Surely it must be party time.
Good idea.
We like to party. We like to party. We like to party. We like to party.
until the break of day, through this house each fairy stray, trip away, make not stay, meet me all by break of day.
If we shadows have offence, think but this ender, all is mended, that you have but slumbered here, while these visions disappear. And in this weak and idle scene, no more yielding, but a dream.
Closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
I can't
12, action.
Asleep, my love. What? Dead, my dove.
Could reception have some rubbers, please? Erasers, we need a few. Thank you.
That was brilliant. A little bit, Evie.
Right.
Right, remember to look at the camera. Scene 8, action.
You can't blossom, you people love. What have you come my night and stolen my love's heart from him?
Bye bye.
Action. Quick, guys, we've got to finish this. Guys, can you help me, please?
Okay.
Can you grab a paintbrush?
Party
scene, action. Action.
Up and down, up and down.
No, stop. I'll say, because you were, you need to give it a few seconds. Scene 6, action. Scene 5, action.
How unfortunate to meet you here in the moonlight, crowd.
What jealous, Oberon.
Come on, fairies, let's go.
Come on, fairies, let's go.
Scene 3, action.
What speed, Ben?
No, she's not in shop. Hello? Is anyone there? Hey, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Snap. Can you hear me?
Okay, stop.
Come now, what revels are in hand? Is there no play to ease the anguish of a torturing hour? Call Philostrate.
5, action.
I tell you, I...
the lines are...
Oh,